Hey guys, it is time for another video. First of all, I would like to say I am so sorry that it's been so long since I've posted. I've had a lot going on in my life, including the fact that I had a back injury. I don't know what I did. It was probably from all the My name is Josh Adams. I'm on a mission to live out my bucket list as I work to achieve a healthy lifestyle. It won't always be easy, but I look forward to the adventures that lie ahead. Welcome to the world of Josh Adams. Today, I'm going to do a story time vlog for you guys. So one of the coolest experiences of my life so far was that I was invited to be a guest on the Oprah Winfrey Show. So it was really, really cool. I got a call out of the blue. I was at work. And you know what? I've actually posted a video talking about this, which I'm going to post a link to up here, so you can kind of go and watch some of that. Unfortunately, I wasn't allowed to take the camera backstage with me, so I don't have any footage from when I was actually there, from inside anyway. I did get some footage outside the studio. But let me tell you, it was one of the coolest experiences of my life. I felt like I was treated like royalty almost. I mean, they took care of everything. They had a driver pick me up from my house, drive me to the airport. And when I got to the airport, of course, I flew up to Chicago and they had a driver waiting for me. They actually had another guest who was on the show with me and he flew in at the same time that I did. So they picked both of us up together. And he was actually really cool. His name is Jason. He was a survivor of the Columbine shooting. And then he ended up turning to drugs and he was eventually his family did an intervention for him as well on the show, just like me. And so Oprah was doing a follow-up episode talking about intervention, and she had a couple of guests who had been on the show come and appear on her show. So it was kind of like a follow-up episode type deal, and it was really, really an honor to be on her show. I remember when I got the call, I was so excited. And my parents, they were on a cruise, so I had called them. And back then, it was really kind of hard to get a hold of someone when they were on a cruise ship. So I remember calling in and like taking a chance on if they would even be in their stateroom. And so I called and my dad actually picked up the phone and I was like, oh my gosh, you're not going to believe what's going on. I got a phone call. And I was like, because they charged like $15 a minute or whatever it was, I was just like trying to rush and speak as much as I could in a short amount of time. So I was like, Dad, you're not going to believe what happened. I got a phone call from the Oprah Winfrey Show and I'm going to be on the show next week. I love you guys. I'll talk to you later. I'll tell you more all about it. I wish you could be there. Goodbye. It was like, I'm sure my dad was just like, okay. But yeah, it was, I could not contain my excitement. And then of course, you know, because I had been on TV before and at that point I had kind of hit like a plateau in my weight loss. And so I guess the self-conscious part of me was like, I gotta lose as much weight as I possibly can between now and like a week later when I was gonna be on the show. It was a pretty quick timeline, like from the time that I got the call to the time that they actually did the taping, I want to say it was maybe a week or a week and a half at the most, so it was pretty quick. But so as soon as I got to Chicago, it was the evening before the taping, and they took us by the studio first because they had bought a suit for me, and I had bought like a button-down shirt, and I had gone and gotten like a fitting and everything. And but I couldn't afford like a suit or a suit jacket, and I didn't have anything like that. So I just went up there with this nice button-down shirt. Well, they ended up buying me a suit, and they actually bought three suits because they weren't sure exactly what size I would be. And they wanted to make sure it would fit. So they bought three suits in three different sizes. And so I went and tried them on, and we found one that fit. And so that was what we ended up going with. So then they took us back to the hotel for that night, and they'd given us like a, I think it was like a $100 room tab so we could get food there, you know. So, and it was a super nice, I just remember it was a super nice hotel and I had like a really great view. Like I could see the Sears Tower, whatever it's called now. But anyway, I could see that and I could see the river and it was just a really beautiful view. And I really felt like, I mean, I was still young at that point. I think I was 25 and I had never done anything like that before. So it was definitely very surreal. And I remember when they came and brought my room service, I remember telling the guy, I was like, the tip is on, it's on Oprah. It's so stupid. So then we go to the taping, right, the next morning. And we had an early call. I want to say I had to be up at like 6 or 7. It was pretty early. And so we go downstairs, and they had, like, this time they had a limo for us. So I really felt like we were getting the royal treatment at that point. So Jason and I both got in the car. They took us over to the studio. And so, of course, we were there early, you know, before they let the studio audience in. I just remember having, like, a team of people helping kind of get everything coordinated before they started the taping. Now, what they don't tell you about those shows is that you have, like, a segment producer. And the segment producer, their job is to basically have an interview already set up, like pre-planned questions of what Oprah's going to ask. And, of course, Oprah can improvise and ask things that are off script. But collectively, there's kind of like a guideline of what's going to be talked about, right? So I had taken some of my jeans with me from when I was at my heaviest. And, of course, at that point, I had lost all my weight. So I remember having my jeans with me, and I was going to show them. But we ended up running out of time on the segment, so we never got to that. But beforehand, so they kind of prep you. They go back over the questions again of what she's going to ask. And while they're doing that, they're doing hair and makeup. And I just remember that the makeup was, like, airbrushed on. So, you know, they put it all on. And she asked me if I wanted to have a tan. So I remember being like, well, yeah, you can make me a little tan. And, of course, now I look back on it, I'm still, you know, pasty as hell. But whatever. I glow in the dark. Like, I'm translucent. Like, I'm the type of body type that when I go out in the sun, like, I smell bacon, and then I realize, oh, that's me. Like, it's terrible. So, got done with the hair and makeup, and then I dressed up in the suit at that point. So, they had me put on the suit. And I remember they took me out onto the set because there was a whole big discussion about what color the background should be on the set. So, they had me stand up there, and I mean, it felt like probably 10 or 15 minutes of them just conversating about what color the background should be. So that was pretty cool. So then they took me back to my room, and, like, each of us had our own little green room that we were in. And I remember the halls were, like, decorated with all these photos of Oprah with every celebrity known to man. So by this point, it was starting to get close to taping time. So I remember they had, like, a team, like an entourage of people kind of there in the room. So there was, like, the segment producer, the hair and makeup people were there. There was a producer from A&E, which is what Intervention is aired on. And so I had, like, my little entourage of people, you know. And then at that point, I remember standing in the doorway about ready to go out. And I didn't realize that Oprah was going to walk through at that point. But she literally just came walking right through the little hallway there. And I was just like, there's Oprah. And I just remember being struck by how big her hair was. Like, it just looked giant in person. But on TV, it looked fine, you know. But I don't know. She didn't really say anything at that point. And I just remember at that point, they took me out into the studio audience, and everybody was already there and seated. So I remember, like, when I walked out, you could kind of hear, like, a bunch of whispers, like, oh, who is that? Because they had me come and they set me down, like, right on the front row. And then they brought Oprah out, and it was like pandemonium. I mean, like, the crowd went nuts. People were crying and screaming, and it was just, you know, like the Beatles had arrived. And so Oprah comes out and she sits down. And I remember, like, before they started the taping, they kind of, like, warmed up the audience a little bit. Like, I don't know who this was, but there was a woman in the audience who wanted to get a picture taken with Oprah. And so they let her come up there. And so there was a whole big, like, banter between the two of them about which side is their good side. And Oprah was like, well, this is my good side. And the woman was like, well, this is my good side. Anyway, it was cute. So they took a picture together. And then it was time to start the taping, right? So they start the taping. And so Oprah's, like, talking about me. And there's a big picture of me that showed up on the screen behind her. And that's when I started getting nervous, right? Because she kind of did, like, a little intro of the piece. And then they went right into a little video package. So the video is playing on the screen behind her. And I'm, like, I had been fine up until that point. But at that point, I really got nervous. And then she kind of, like, looked at me while the video was playing and winked. And I was just like, okay, it's going to be okay. Like, oh my God, Oprah just winked at me. But so then I went up there, and I just remember being, like, super, the night before I couldn't sleep because I was like, how do I greet her? Do I shake her hand, or do I hug her or bow at her feet? Or, like, I just didn't know how to react. And, but no, it just was very natural. Like, went up on the stage, she hugged me, and then they went to a commercial break. And I was, like, scared to say anything to her during the commercial because she had, like, these little note cards, you know, and she's, like, looking at her notes. And we only broke for, like, 30 seconds maybe, and then they came right back. And then we did the interview, and it just went by. I just remember it went by so fast. Like, it just felt like that, and it was done. And then when it got done, they did this segment with the other guy, and so he went out and did his interview. And they actually, on the real episode, had three guests, but when we were there, we only taped the two of us, and then I guess the other guest had taped at a previous time. So we got done with the taping, and then she did a series of questions and answers with the crowd, and I remember, I just remember her being really funny. Like, she was talking about how she had a pimple on her forehead, and she was like, "Y'all, it is the size of Idaho," and she's like, "Can you see it?" And you could. It was really funny. So, there you have it. Oprah gets pimples too. But yeah, and then they took me backstage, and I just remember, you know, that anyone who got to ask a question of Oprah was allowed to come back and get a picture taken with her. And I just remember everyone going crazy, like, you know, like sobbing over her and just being crazy. And so I just remember trying to play it cool. Like, I was an Oprah fan, but I didn't, like, religiously watch her show. So I wasn't like, "Oh my God, Oprah." But I was, you know, I was still aware of the magnitude of the star power of who she is, you know. So I was obviously grateful to meet her. And she was just super nice, very polite, you know. It was just a really good experience. And I know some people don't care for Oprah. But, you know, I can only speak from my experience with her. She was super nice. The experience was really incredible, and I'm very grateful for it. So I have a picture in my hallway of me and Oprah. So it's kind of a cool little memento to have. You know, a lot of people have asked me what it's like to be on TV or to go through that experience or what it was like. And I think I don't regret it at all because, you know, it is my story. And there have been countless people who have reached out to me and said that, you know, watching my story has helped. But where I wish that I wasn't so hard on myself is that I put a lot of pressure on myself because I felt like all these people were watching my story and had seen me on TV. And especially like right after it aired, I was getting recognized when I would go in public, and it was a very surreal experience. And so I just felt like all these eyes were on me. And so I had to do it perfectly. And, you know, it was a lot of pressure. So as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, I hurt my back. And I was down for probably a good week and a half with that injury. To the point where, like, I couldn't get out of bed almost. I mean, there was one day where I think I literally got out of bed twice the whole day. Because any movement at all just hurt. But thankfully, it's been better. I went to see a chiropractor. And he gave me some tips on how I can reduce the inflammation, and it seems to be working. So that is good. Because of that downtime, I missed 2 weeks worth of dance lessons, which was not good. But I took a lesson yesterday, so it's been going well. I'm certainly making improvements, and I just wish my stamina was better. It's not quite where I want it to be yet, but that's going to take some time. And, you know, as far as, like, the diet is concerned, I have not been doing well since Memorial Day weekend, probably, I think. It's just been not so good. But, you know what? That's the reality. I think I've been in kind of a little bit of a slump emotionally, and I think that's kind of played a factor in it, too, so I'm telling on myself so that I get out of that funk. I want to wish a very happy birthday, and this is a belated birthday, to my good friend Nando. Check out his YouTube channel. I'm going to put a link down below. He's a really cool guy. He's got a great YouTube channel. Check out his content, and happy birthday, Nando. So, I really want to work on growing this channel, and I've been thinking of some ideas of how I can do that by upping my subscriber count. I think what I'm going to do is start doing some giveaways. So every milestone for subscribers, I'll do a giveaway to anyone who wants to sign up. So how I'm going to do this, I'm working on building a website, and it is joshadamsbucketlist.com. I'll put a link down below. If you go there and sign up for my mailing list, anyone who signs up for the mailing list will be entered into a drawing for the giveaways. My goal is for when I hit 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to give away something. As the milestones get bigger and bigger, hopefully the prizes will get bigger and bigger too. So I'm super excited about that. Please spread the word. Share. If you're enjoying what you're seeing, please like the video down below and subscribe to my channel and spread the word. Tell your friends. The next story time video that I'm going to do, I will tell the story about when I got to go attend a taping of The Oprah Show while Celine Dion was a guest. So that was pretty cool. And I'll tell you all about that on my next story time video, which I'm going to post that next week. That is going to do it for today. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.